ब्रह्मानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्याधिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। Last portion of our series of discourse, the path of meditation ending. Day before yesterday, we saw the path of meditation starting. Yesterday, path of meditation walking. Today, path of meditation ending. The great spiritual navigator, Patanjali Yoga Sutras, they have begun to say their ending. They also have to end. That is why they are running as fast as possible. We saw about the yama, niyama, pranayama, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara. All these five we finished. Now we will understand the dharana, dhyana and samadhi. We need to know surely about the ending. People may think, why should we know about the ending of the meditation? Why should we know about the end? If we know how to start and how to walk, that's enough. But if you don't know how to end, most of the time you make a big mistake. Either you end much earlier, or you continue to walk missing the goal where you are supposed to stop. Both are the big mistakes. By doing both, you will miss the destination. Yeah. Small story. Mugund started one day to Miami Beach to spend his vacation. Got into the Florida highway, drove. Suddenly, in 3 days, he was back to his house. Didn't spend the vacation in the beach. People in the neighborhood asked, what happened? Why did you come back? Why are you back again? Mukund replied, I saw a big board, Miami Beach left, so I came back. Saw a big board, signboard which says Miami Beach left. Then I thought, oh, Miami Beach has left, so I came back. Most of the time, by not knowing where to end, we miss the destination. We do not even know where to end our practices, our spiritual practices, our meditation techniques. Knowledge or the wisdom about the ending gives you the clarity not only where to end, where you should not end. Both are given to you by the clarity of the path of meditation ending. Let me explain few things about the ending, then we will enter into the subject. Spirituality, much prior to the enlightenment, much prior to the real thing which is to be achieved. The main thing Patanjali says is miraculous powers. Miraculous powers are the place where you think you are reached. It's like you enter the train thinking to reach Madras. From Bangalore you get into the train thinking of reaching the Madras. In between you find some city which is colorful, big, looks very rich. Immediately you think this is the Madras, this is the destination. You get down from the flight, you get down from the train. Of course, if you go by flight, you have no problem. Train is journey by yourself. Flight is going with the grace of the master. With the grace of the master, you don't have the problem. You will exactly land where you are supposed to land. But most of us travel only by ourselves. Most of us don't get the nearness or the presence of the guru, presence of the master. At least the people who live in the West, they have to be naturally travel on themselves, travel on their own. They cannot have the nearness of the master. Of course, once you are near the master, it's more or less like a flight journey. You don't need to do anything. Everything will be served directly to you. Miracle powers are the powers with which your growth, your spiritual growth can be stopped. You may think that you have reached the goal. What are the miracle powers? There are thousands and thousands of miracle powers which can be achieved by this meditation. When you start or when you walk, Patanjali says on thousands and thousands of miracle powers. I'll explain to you the basic miracles, basic powers which you gain. Actually, if you read Patanjali deeply, if you read the Yoga Sutras, you understand there is no such thing as miracle in the world. Whatever happens is just a clear science. When you don't know the logic, it is a miracle. If you know the logic, nothing is miracle. Imagine, for example, understand one thing. Suddenly, by some war or a natural calamity, all the radios in the world are lost. Only one man has got only one piece of radio. All the radio is lost. Only one person has got only one piece of radio. Then what will become? What will happen to him? He will be just worshipped as a god. Because he will say, I have a one box which can sing by itself, which can give the news by itself. If you just tune to that box will tell you when the earthquake is going to come, when the flood is going to come, when the rain is going to come. If I tune to the box, that can sing. If I tune to the box, that can tell stories. If you have only one radio in the whole world, the man who is having the radio will become a god. Because it looks like something extraordinary. Nobody knows what it is. Nobody knows how it functions. Nobody knows the logic or the science in which it works. When nobody knows the logic or the science, how it works, the way in which it functions, then that thing will be called as a miracle. But when you know the way in which it works, the way in which the message or the waves are relayed, the way in which radio is tuned, the way in which radio starts singing or telling the stories or giving you the news. When everything is known, it is no more a miracle, just an ordinary thing. When things are not known, it is more or less like a miracle. The same way, all the miracles, whatever you see in the spiritual world, I can tell you in a serial way some five special kind of miracles which you find in the spiritual personalities. First thing, telling the future. telling the, predicting the future is the first kind of miracle power. The second thing, Janavasya. Whomsoever sees them, they will not be able to forget them. The whole mass will be just mesmerized. Just they will follow them. They will follow wherever the master goes. The power of Janavasya. The third thing, materialization. Materializing the vigrahas, materializing the ash, materializing the objects, that teleporting the objects, that is the third power. The fourth, whatever they utter will become reality. The fifth, ultimate power, power to heal the disease, power to destroy the karma. These are the five levels of powers, five levels of miracles. If the logic, if the path to achieve these powers, if it is not known, they are miracles, just like the radio. If you know very clearly how to have each and every power, and what is the technique, and what is the method to have the powers, and how you can handle those powers, it is no more a miracle. It is just, anybody can have it, anybody can achieve it. It is only one dimension of your own being. If you doesn't know how to use the radio, the secrets of radio, the science of radio, you will look at it as a miracle. When you know the whole secret, it is just an ordinary thing. Same way, whatever you see in the name of miracle in the spiritual world, all these five great powers are nothing but the clear spiritual expression, the energy expression in different chakras. In different chakras, a man who knows the logic will understand it is just a science anybody can achieve.